Hey guys, Nicole Cooper here, wanting to just share some relocation tips and things that I've learned in the process of us relocating. I really think that some of the things that I've learned will be extremely beneficial. So just wanted to give it to all of you guys out there and share it with all of you guys out there who are in the process of making this move. The first thing that I want to share with you guys is to plan. Plan ahead of time. Plan ahead of time on the process of how you're going to, you know, pretty much make the adjustment and the transition. And I'm really talking from a relocation standpoint where you're leaving a city and actually going to a new city. You want to plan ahead because from a packing standpoint, or just starting to eliminate things, you want to give yourself at least 2 to 3 months beforehand to go through things, go and see what you want to keep, see what you want to sell, see what you want to trash. Kind of like that whole rhythmatic thing that they do on these organizing shows. And the reason why is because you really can make a decent amount of income selling the things that you don't need anymore. Otherwise, you'll be like me, just giving stuff away at the last minute because you really can't take it with you. You have no need for it and you don't really have time to go through the process. So if you want to create some income that can help fund the move, plan ahead. Also, plan ahead financially. You know, making a move and relocating to another city, unless it's a corporate move where they're covering the cost for you, it can be a pretty lofty cost. You know, we are just leaving, going two states over. We're leaving Tennessee to go to Texas. And this move cost us all in all, from, you know, security deposits to the pods, to the shipping of the cars, to the hotel fees, to the paying of closing out in our current place, you know, carpet cleaning and housekeeping and all the little miscellaneous things in between, buying boxes and everything like that. It ran us about $15,000. I'm not trying to scare you. That's just what it cost us because of all the different things that we actually had to do. And then the cushion, the money, the financial cushion that we wanted to leave ourselves so that we can be able to have money to kind of work around with unexpected expenses. Because for us, we had two cars that ended up, you know, needing to be fixed that cost us an additional like $2,500 to get fixed. We had to get new tires, oil change, tire rotations, and all these things. Then we had to ship cars, you know. So it was just an endless amount of things that we had to do. And if you want to learn how to fund your relocation, go to makemoneywithnicole.com because my company pretty much covered my entrepreneurial company, the venture that I'm in. I pretty much covered my costs, but I will highly suggest that you plan ahead financially and also plan ahead on the process in which you're going to pack. I also want to encourage you to make sure that you identify who's gonna help you? Who's gonna help you pack? Are you gonna hire a company to come do everything where they pack, they load, and they ship for you? Or are you gonna pack everything yourself? You know, what is the process gonna be like? Are you gonna do a U-Haul? You know, do you gonna wanna get the pods? Do you wanna get the trailer company? You know, or you know, are you gonna use a company like Atlas or some of these other companies that we've used or got quotes from? I would say those are pretty pricey. However, when you have someone come and do it all for you, it's usually done for commercial reasons if people are relocating corporately, but it's probably the best thing you can do. However, there are workarounds because some people are working at different budgets. If you have a pretty good budget, hire a company. I know we got some price quotes for people to come and do everything for us. And it turned out that it was like, two companies, we got two quotes. The first quote was like $7,500. Just roll the window down, let some air in. The first company was like $7,500. And then the second company was like $10,500. So we ended up, we checked on pods. Pods were a little too small for us. They were kind of too narrow, it was just too short. So we ended up using Pack Rat. We actually still have it over there if you can see it. I don't know if you can see it. But we ended up using Pack Rat and we got two of them. And it cost us about $3,500, and some change. And what we did, because they don't allow you to park them like on the grass or on the street or anything like that, cause you have to end up getting, a permit from the city and it's a little bit of a headache. They dropped one off first and then they come and they pick it up. And they'll drop off another one. But here's a suggestion, you guys. You know, the first one, load, if you're going to use a company like that, we found out the hard way, it takes 7 to 10 days, business days, for you to get your stuff. So like we got our things sent off. It hasn't left yet. It was supposed to leave yesterday, but the pack rat truck broke down. And so they had to come back and supposed to pick it up either today or tomorrow. We potentially won't get our stuff. Today is the 30th of May. We may not get our stuff until June 12th or the 13th. That is like the 10-day window, or even the 14th, I think, which means that we will get to our location and won't have many things there with us to start out. The fortunate thing for us is we're pretty much going to be getting some new furniture and things, and we're moving right down the street from IKEA. So for the kids, you know, IKEA is kind of cheapy furniture, but we can get some things for the kids inexpensively from there. So we're going to get them new beds. And, you know, for us, me and my husband, I mean, we could rough it on a pull-out, a mattress, a blow-up mattress and things like that. Like, we can rough it. It's no biggie for us. But my suggestion is, in your first, number one, ship them off early, ahead of time. And when you ship them off early, ahead of time, make sure that you put your most important things that you need first in the first pod, if you're going to do different pods. Two, I think these are like 8x16 or something like that. And these did pretty well for us. We were able to get our entire house in these, and our home size is about 2400 square feet. The house that we're moving out of, it was like a four bedroom, two bath home. And just the fourth bedroom was upstairs, a bonus room. So, we didn't have a lot of furniture cause we got rid of a lot of stuff. But we pretty much could hold everything we needed in there. Couches, beds, and things like that. Dining table, patio furniture, and things like that. But make sure you guys send your stuff ahead of time, that you need the most so that it can be there to greet you. Also, if you're relocating, make sure you know all the utility companies that you're going to need. A lot of these companies, you got to plan in advance, and make sure that you have everything covered. So we had multiple different companies to go through. We had the power company was one. Then we had the water company that was different. You know, then we had to set up our internet. That was another company. Some companies, sewage is different. Our trash company is different. The gas company was different. So, you know, you had to go through all these different companies, one for gas, one for power, one for water. And then some of them require deposits. You know, some of them, they have to come out to the house and you have to be there. You know, so you want to call and get all that information early. Also, another tip is if you're traveling with kids and you're going through the process, make sure that you know where they're going to be while you're going through the process of packing, on the front end and on the back end when you get there. This can be a very challenging experience for children. My kids are young. I have a 5-year-old and a 1-year-old. They're antsy, you know, they're irritable. The transition is so big for them. They don't quite know what's going on, but they're uncomfortable because there's nights that they're not going to be sleeping in their bed. So you have to find a way to make the process easier. And I think one of the best things is to keep them busy. So what we did drop-in care. That was another added expense, where they went to a place in Memphis. It's called Kid Station. It's like a Chuck E. Cheese for kids with arts and crafts and things like that. But it's a drop-in care. So we took them there for a couple of days. And then when we get there, we have a service that we're going to be taking them to, allowing them to go to. And it's costly. These things cost, but make sure your kids have somewhere to go and something to do, in the transition. And then another thing, another tip that I want to share is, you know, after you get everything done, guys, whether you're moving it, whether you're hiring a company to do it, whatever it may be, if you're making the drive across to the new city, and if you have the time, the beautiful thing about me being an entrepreneur is I'm not on anybody's schedule. My husband is now working from home as well. So we don't have the pressure of having to be somewhere by certain dates. Then it's the beginning of summer, so the kids are out of school. So we don't have to worry about dates of school and all that stuff. But if you can, before you get on that road, give yourself a chance to rest. Just relax. What we did is we went on ahead and got us some suites at the hotel, 2-bedroom suite, where the kids had their own room and space and place. And my husband and I had our own room, you know, free Wi-Fi, and just relax. Take care of all of the knick-knack things. Don't rush off and be so anxious to leave that you leave business unattended behind. Because there's still a lot of little things that we had to do. We had to close bank accounts. We had to make sure all business was handled with our house. We had to make sure that we got the kids immunization records and had them in our hand and got their shots and things before we left. We had to change insurance, you know, so we had to get all those things taken care of. Just a lot of things. We had to get our mail. Make sure you forward your address 10 business days in advance as well, because they need that much to change it. Otherwise, you end up having a lot of mail that get lost in a shuffle and also go into all of your accounts and change your address. So these are things, guys, that I've learned. These are just a couple of tips that I'm shooting off the top of my head that I know were very critical. But you want to make sure you rest. We are so tired. And yes, we can get on that road, but it is a 13-hour trip. And then we know when we get there, it's going to be hustle and bustle trying to get prepared to move stuff in and all that stuff. Even though we have a couple of weeks before it gets there, but we just kind of wanted to relax and take care of business. So we got the hotel suite and we gave ourselves 2 days to just kind of relax so that when we get on the road, even in that process, have the budget to stop and rest when necessary so that you don't overdo it and overwork yourself. In closing, I know this is a pretty long video, but in closing, one of the things that I want to share with you guys that is also very critical is to understand that you have an option, right? The first option is to work yourself to the bone trying to save money. You could do everything yourself, but you can wear yourself thin. And when you get frustrated and tired and exhausted like that, guys, you're just no good. Or you can prepare and plan ahead financially to pay people to help do things and make things easier. We paid some moving, I think the website's called movinghelp.com. It's from U-Haul. And we paid some guys to come and take all the heavy furniture and load it on the pods and let them figure out how to get the stuff on there. Do you know how much we paid them for 2-3 hours worth of work? $116. $116 for two guys to come and they lifted all the heavy stuff and they did all of that. You can also use that company to come pack your things and they'll come clean your house. But that's another thing. We didn't clean our own house. We paid somebody to come clean the house. We didn't clean the carpet and deal with all that. We paid somebody to clean the carpet. You know, there's a lot of things that you can choose to do yourself and wear yourself out, or you can put the money aside and pay to get it done. And for most people, they don't have the budget to pay. But that's what I'm saying, guys. You know, you need to work some level of an entrepreneurial venture that brings in disposable income to help pay for those things to make your life easier. And if you don't know where to go, you can go to my website, makemoneywithnicole.com, and I'll show you how, because my company, like I said, they covered those costs. And money creates convenience. And so the income that I make, instead of blowing it on things, it actually helps make my life easier to give me more time and more energy. And despite the fact that I'm tired, because there was a lot of mental preparation and things, a lot of things you got to get done. You got to get a pediatrician for the kids. You got to find a school for the kids. You got to get the kids' school records. You got to get the immunization records. You know, it's a lot of things that we had to do in preparation of this move. It helped to have additional helping hands to make the process smoother. So hopefully for all of you out there that are relocating, I am hoping that these tips benefited you in some way, shape, or form. I know you guys know I'm all over the place when I talk off my dome, but I just didn't have time to write things down. I just wanted to kind of share as things were on the top of my head. So I might do a part two to this, but hopefully this has helped you. So guys, I look forward to getting your feedback if this helped you in your relocation process. And congratulations if you're moving to your dream city like I am. Make your life easier by investing and planning ahead so that you can get to where you need to be with all the energy, vigor, and excitement possible. All right, guys. So thanks so much. And if you want to learn more about what I do, go to makemoneywithnicole.com. Bye-bye.
My baby's sleeping.